Hey there, what is up? This is Flutter Mentor, and today we're going to learn how to validate text form fields. This is a very simple UI, just has a submit button to submit the form, which is just a two-field form, and it's all wrapped within a builder for snack bar purposes. And our goal will be to create a validation method that only accepts names with over 3 characters and an age that is over 18. We're going to do it very simply, just so you can understand how the validation works, and let's get to it. The first thing we're going to need is a form key. I'm going to type in the more extensive way and also show you the shorter way. This will be it. If you want to make it shorter, just type in this instead. Either way will work the same. It's entirely up to you. And then you just wrap it. You could wrap the padding or the column. It will be up to you, but I'm going to wrap the column with the form widget. And the only thing you do with the form widget is you give it the key that you just created, like so. And now let's actually define the kind of validation that you want to happen. And by the way, this only works with text form field. If you use text field, you will not have the validator property. Text fields are just used for simpler use cases. In the text form field, you would use the validator property. And this property takes an anonymous function that carries a value. And then, as you can see, it's already giving me squiggly lines. That's because this function has got to return something of type string. And that string will be the message that you want displayed underneath the text field alongside your error, which would be your error message. Now, the order in which you define the rules isn't too important. Sometimes it could be, depending on what you use for validation. But either way, when you want it to validate, you need to return null instead of a string. That's how you tell the validator that that's what you want to be accepted. I usually use return as the first case, but you can use it as the last case if you want. And in this case, for the full name, I'm going to type in if value is not empty and value.length is more or equal to 3, or it could just be is more than 2, then I would like to return null, which means we're a go. Accept the input and let's go to the next stage. But if this isn't the case, then let me set up some rules. Else if value.length is less than 3 and value is not empty, and you'll understand why I put in this just now, then return no way your name is that short. And this is just a joke. I know people who have 2 characters in their name. I'm just messing around here. Else, and this is just in any other case scenario, return please give us your name already. And the reason I added the end value is not empty here is because I want this to display if the user tries to submit something completely empty. But it's basically just to show you're going to have multiple different rules for different situations. And now let's do this to the age text form field. Once again, use the validator property. Same thing here, an anonymous function. And now to change it up, I'm going to return null as the last case scenario. In this case, if value is empty. And I'm just trying to show you guys different ways to do this. Return, please enter your damn age. I wanted to create a validator that was a little bit impatient because I feel that validators are just way too nice. And now in this part, we're going to focus on checking if the age is over 18 or not. Now, you got to remember that whatever the user inputs on the text form field is a string. And what we want is to measure the value of an int. So what you need to do is int dot, you can either use parse or triparse. Triparse is usually safer, but either way you should be fine. And then you input the value. And then all you gotta do is say, if this value is lower than 18, well, in that case, return this ain't for kids under 18. And as you can see, the squiggly line still shows up because you just have to end it in an else statement. So there are no open possibilities. And in this case, I just return null because I want to accept all other case scenarios. Of course, this could be more complicated. This could have rejects. I could say I'll only accept if it's possible to parse it into an int, etc. But I'm trying to keep this simple. And if you think we're done, you would be wrong because over here on the text button, all the unpressed does is a snack pretty much. You click it and there it is. So this isn't what we want. We need to create a logic to first check if it's validated. And then if it is, it can run the remaining code. And it's not complicated at all. All you gotta do is type in if, and basically what you need to do here is access the form key dot current state dot validate. Now this returns a bool, and if it validates the form, it will be true. So what you want is to check if it's false. If it is, then you just return here. In this case, I don't want to run any of the other code, so I just do that. But the submission logic is something that will be specific to your project. In this case, if it doesn't validate, it doesn't run the snack bar. If everything's working, the snack bar shows up. That's the logic behind it. Let me restart the app. and everything should work just fine. If I submit it like this, there you go. The two errors are right there. As you can see, please give us your name already and please enter your damage. Both in case it's empty and both used in different ways. And now let's type in just two letters and say we're 15 years old. Let's see what happens now. There it is. No way your name is that short. And the same for kids under 18. Everything seems to be working properly. Now let's do with three letters and make this kid 18. What would happen now? We're validated and we got your name and age. So personally, I would say we nailed this one. Thank you for watching. Please drop a like if this helped you. Subscribe if you want to keep on learning Flutter. That's it for now. This is Flutter Mentor and out.